When we confront others, we demonstrate love and humility by speaking with patience and gentleness. Galatians 6 and 1 reads about that. Most often, others will treat you as you treat them. If you are aggressive and overbearing, don't be surprised if an argument develops. If you are patient and gentle, they will probably respond in a similar manner. The best way to test your words is simply ask yourself, is what I'm saying or about to say likely to please God, please or honor God? Just like you just said, am I doing right or what am I saying? The way I'm talking to somebody, is it pleasing God? The way I'm acting towards somebody, is it pleasing God? 7, be quick to listen. The second element of effective communication is the ability to listen carefully to what others are saying. This is not a skill that comes natural to most of us. James 1 and 19 talks about that. Quiet, patient listening does several things. It demonstrates genuine humility. It shows that you realize you do not have all the answers. It tells the other person that you value his or her thoughts and opinion. It's just like you said a while ago, somebody always knowing everything. Somebody always knowing everything. Got an answer for everything. Got a solution for everything. Got an answer for everything. One of the fundamental elements of effective listening is simply waiting patiently while others talk. This is often very difficult. And it is for some people. Some people don't even let you finish the sentence before they interrupt. That is so rude. I think that is, to me, because that's what I had to deal with the children with sometimes too. I use the children as an example because I deal with the children on a day-to-day basis. And I see some of the things that they do in the classroom. You could be, an adult could be talking. And I would tell them, I've already taught them that they say, excuse me, and wait for a response. Just don't blurt right in. You wait for the teacher to respond to you or the adult to respond to you. But one little boy in there, he gonna get his point through no matter what. So what I do is I just look, don't have to say anything. And he go right back over the carpet, he sit down. And he waits until I come over there to say whatever it is he gonna say. And then I say, now what would that young gonna say? And then he respond. See, it's a way of always listening at people. But let them get their point of view out before you rudely interrupt somebody, because it might be something that's detrimental to somebody that somebody really got to get out. And you always intervening before somebody else finished. That's disrespectful and rude. Mm-hmm. Unless you learn to wait as others talk, you will seldom get to the root of the problem and may complicate matters with inappropriate reaction. I just said that. 3 common problems send us away while others talk. Jumping to premature conclusions. We are rehearsing our response in our mind while they are still talking. I'm guilty of that. I sure am. I have done it. Interrupting others while they are speaking. The human mind can think at least 4 times faster than a person can talk. Being comfortable while silent. Now we're talking about be quick to listen. That's what we're talking about. Be quick to listen. Being uncomfortable while silent. After carefully listening, agree with and acknowledge what you know is true before going to points of disagreement. And that's what I was telling my husband about that yesterday. I was talking on this yesterday. That a lot of times, people have a problem with telling the truth. People have a serious problem about telling the truth. And that was one of the things that God had gave me in the Irish speech too. One of the 6 things that would not stand before God. And if I make a mistake, the first one is a liar. By making
so the Bible says that a liar won't even tarry in God's sight. So what it's saying is that a liar won't even see God.
Let me say,
he won't even stand before God, because God says, no, I don't want to have nothing to do with that. Because guess who's a liar? The devil is a liar. Mm-hmm. He is the father of lies. He is the author of lies. Mm-hmm. So if you're lying, then you're serving him.
You know, we talk about gossip, and here's some fruit information right here. There is nothing so delicious as the taste of gossip. It melts in your mouth. We love a good gossiper. It matters. It's a matter of controlling no secrets of others' lives. We should. An evil man sows strife. Gossip separates the best of friends. Keep your mouth closed and you'll stay out of trouble. Without wood, a fire goes out. Without gossip, a quarrel dies down. Now here go the lion. There are six things which the Lord hates, seven which are abomination to him. Haughty eyes, a lying tongue. God can't stomach liars. He loves the company of those who keep their word. Lying has pervaded our very culture down to the core. We are taught to lie not to hurt someone's feelings. Am I fat? Ugly? Does my outfit look good? To protect ourselves, family, and others to get ahead. He who winks his eyes playing perverse things. He who compresses his lips bring evil to pass. We're talking about that life. Bread gained by deceitful is sweet to a man, but after his mouth will he fall when he full of gravel. The getting of treasure by a lying tongue is a fleet vapor of a snare of death. God can't stomach liars. That means he swallow. His stomach won't take lies. He can't stand liars. It makes him sick in his stomach for liars to stand before him, knowing that they have lied. He loves the company of those who keep his word. Proverbs 12 and 22 talks about that. Lying lips are an abomination. The Lord detests lying lips. Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking lies. Lies will get any man into trouble, but honesty is its own defense. Here's an illustration. Remember the boy who cried wolf? The story about the boy who cried wolf.
Yeah.
Better to be poor and honest than a rich man no one can trust. A false witness will go unpunished, and he who utter lies will not escape. A false witness will not go unpunished, and he who utter lies will perish. We're talking about that lying tongue. That means you can't tell the truth. You can't tell the truth. Just a lie that's in you. It's just in it, and people need to be delivered from lying too. But that's a spirit too. This is so important, especially if you have been in the wrong. Example, you are right. I was wrong when I said a lot of what you have said is true. See, it's simple as that. But you can't even get people to admit that they're wrong when they know they're wrong. It is hard to do. For some people, never will admit that they're wrong. Some people die and go to hell, die in their grave with that unforgiveness in their heart. Ain't never told nobody they were sorry for what they have done to them, the hurt that they have caused them, the hurt, the pain, that anything they have done to them. Before they would say that they're sorry, they would take it to their grave with them. If you speak the truth in love and do all you can to confront the other person, effectively.